the leaders in that tough division. Hello, everyone. Dick Enberg with Merlin Olsen. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
Dick, this is not only a time for us to give thanks for the special things that we have in life, but also for the special people in our lives. And we'd like to send along Thanksgiving greetings to all the special people that we have and share those Thanksgivings with.
Well, just like the players, do we want to say hello to our moms, to mine in Bay City, Michigan, and happy Thanksgiving to Merlin's mother out in Logan, Utah. Save us a piece of white meat. You played in this game a couple of times. Is it special for the players?
It is, Dick, not only because of the tradition and the excitement, but also it's a working day for the other teams in the NFL. And they're all gathered in their locker rooms or training rooms and looking at monitors. They're going to be watching this game. You add that to a full national audience, and this game does have a special spotlight.
Well, we have talked about Billy Sims and Franco Harris on NFL 83. No need to go any further there. We'll watch him in action. But how about the quarterbacks? Two men who have migrated up from third string. Cliff Stout, who's taken over for the injured Terry Bradshaw, is the quarterback with the Steelers. And for the Detroit Lions, it's Eric Hipple. Hipple has beaten out Gary Danielson for the top spot.
Dick, neither of these quarterbacks having a great year statistically. Both young quarterbacks. And both coaches would rather rely on their running game if they can today.
There are a lot of traditions surrounding this game. One is the feeling that Thanksgiving Day means defense. The defense has had a shining moment almost every year.
You stop to think about defense in the NFL. Two of the teams you think about instantly, Detroit Lions, Pittsburgh Steelers. Won't be any different today. And one of the ways that defense will be exemplified, great pass rush. Willis and Gary, Gay and English. You're going to be seeing these young men climbing all over quarterbacks on the field today.
All right, then what will be the key to victory?
Dick, I think the running game is the key, and in particular because of the injuries to Detroit. I'm looking for the first down situations for Detroit. They're going to put their man back in that I formation, Billy Sims, and if he can average good yardage on first down against that defense of Pittsburgh, that will be the key to the game for them.
Well, Chuck Knoll, the head man of the Steelers, he has a tough defense.
He certainly was in a good mood when we talked to him last night. Talked about a short week of preparation, said he hoped that they could simplify things and get them off to a fast start in this ballgame today.
Monty Clark, the Detroit Lions head coach in his sixth year. Losing seasons, although they did make it in the playoffs last year with a 4-5 record in that abbreviated strike season. Gary Anderson will kick it off for the Pittsburgh Steelers. On this Thanksgiving Thursday, we're underway. Ken Jenkins, number 31 at his goal line. Oh, is he hit at the 17-yard line as one of the Steelers downfield put a mean hit on him. David Little, number 50, and getting up slowly. Also 81, Paul Scanzi. Eric Hipple, the quarterback for the Lions. His running backs, Vince Thompson for the injured James Jones, and Billy Sims, one of the game's best. The receivers, Mark Nichols, he apparently has beaten out Freddie Scott. Jeff Chadwick, a rookie free agent for the injured Leonard Thompson, and the tight end is Ulysses Norris. First down from the 17. Hipple having to ad-lib his way, and he's out of bounds at the 21-yard line. That's something we expect to see from Cliff Stout, but not from Hipple. It's a gain of about 4. Chris Dietrich is the left tackle as we check the Lions' starting offensive line. Homer Elias from Tennessee State at left guard. Steve Mott, he was a fifth-round draft pick out of Alabama. They really like him here in Detroit. Larry Lee of UCLA is at right guard, and Keith Dorney, an academic All-American and a Pro Bowler last year, is at right tackle. Ben Stater. Second down and 6. Sold out. First time the Lions have played before a home sellout this year. Nichols in motion. And the give to Sims. He's got yardage. He may go all the way now. He's at the 35, the 40. And finally, Dwayne Woodruff brings him down at the 47-yard line. What's that expression you use, Merlin? He's pumped. He's really pumped up.
You better believe he is pumped up, and he's got this crowd excited. Sims with a little shoulder fake, breaking over the left side, and all you need to do is give this man a little bit of room. Dorney getting a great block, runs right out of one tackle by Woods there, and he's off to the races. Dwayne Woodruff, 49, doing a good job of getting over and bringing him down.
30 yards for Sims, first down at the Pittsburgh 48. Sims again. He's got blockers. Cut inside, however, and ran right into Lambert and Cole after a 2-yard gain. Let's check that Pittsburgh defense for you, and they've been outstanding this year. Goodman starts at left defensive end. They make changes on passing downs. Gary Dunn, considered the best of the down linemen at nose tackle, and Tom Beasley opens at right end. The linebackers, Merriweather, the youngster that replaced Jack Ham so well. Jack Lambert leading the team in tackles again. Lauren Taves, the veteran inside, having a big year for them, as is Robin Cole. Maybe his best as a Steeler, according to Noel. Woodruff at one corner, just made that tackle. Veteran Mel Blunt, Donnie Schell, and Rick Woods at free safety. Second and eight. Complete to Norris, the tight end at the 39. Knocked out of bounds. He'll be very close to a first down.
Dick, a basic difference in these two teams. The Pittsburgh Steelers will employ a number of blitzes. They'll also use a lot of zone defenses, whereas Detroit likes to go man-to-man and does not favor the blitz.
Three tight ends sent in by Monty Clark, so Norris, Rubik, and McCall to add blocking strength on third and less than one at the Pittsburgh 38. Just underway on this Thanksgiving Day. It's cold outside. It was rainy yesterday. Temperature dropping rapidly into the 30s. It was comfortable indoors. Hipple on the sneak, and he has plenty of yardage and a first down. A couple of yards for Hipple.
Dick, this is a unique stadium. The crowd is right on top of the field. And this is a tough crowd. If Detroit plays well, they will be a big factor in this game today. If Detroit gets behind by a couple of touchdowns, they may become a factor on the other side in this game.
Yeah, they've been frustrated here in Michigan, Detroit area. Of course, those championship years, 52, 53, 57. But since then, been mighty lean. And the folks in these parts are hungry for a winner. And it's been a roller coaster year for Monty Clark and these Lions. One week they play brilliantly, and then they fade the next. And the record reflects that, 6-6. Sims, and then a reverse to Nichols. 40, 35, 30, and a first down at the 23-yard line.
One of the things you do to a good football team is to take advantage of their reflexes. They put Sims to the outside. They know that every Steeler defensive man is eyeballing Sims, and they come right back with a reverse the other direction. Good play calling and a big first down. Quick look at it. Sims getting the ball, just hands off quickly, and everyone on the defense was pulled to the outside, to the left side. A smart play call. Good block in there by Hipple himself. Driven out of bounds again by Woodruff.
13 yards on the play. The Lions with the opening kickoff, marching deep in Pittsburgh territory. Vince Thompson replacing the injured James Jones. Thompson from Villanova, free agent, actually was out of football, was working as a track coach in Levington, Pennsylvania, when invited to what the Lions called their gong show tryout, where everyone came in, and Thompson won a job. He's a good blocker, a good runner. He's not the receiver that James Jones of Florida, the top pick of the Lions out of Florida, is, and Jones won't play today with a bad rib.
Said he couldn't even bend over yesterday. Hated to be out of this ball game.
Lions are very fond of his talents, Jones. Thompson again, hoping that the Steelers would be keying on Sims, and he battles to the 15. Goodman makes the stop. It'll be third down and a long two.
Ted Marchibroda, the offensive coordinator for the Lions, has really built this Lion offense around the talents of Billy Sims, featuring him and then featuring the kind of frustration he brings to a defense, knowing that they're going to be focusing on him, able to fake to a Sims and give the ball inside to the fullback or go to the passing game.
Here's that mass substitution. The Steelers almost like a hockey team. Over the boards they come. Four new players looking for the pass. Nichols and Chadwick along with Scott. Wide open. First and goal at the 3-yard line. Jeff Chadwick, his 24th catch this year. A free agent out of Grand Valley State up in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Eric Hipple is the kind of quarterback that can hurt you when he gets hot, and he has it going here in the early part of this ball game. Donnie Schell had left the ball game a few moments ago, gets back in and is greeted by this play. Chadwick, an impressive young receiver, very quick in and out of his cuts, simply ran away from the veteran Schell.
Boyce Chadwick, a light 185, a big catch, and it's first and goal as the Lions use three tight ends. Vince Thompson, and a greeting party of Steelers as four white jerseys smother him. Robin Cole, 56, 67, Gary Dunn, Mike Merriweather, 57, all there.
First hit by Merriweather, then Cole just buried him. Good defensive play. Lions are going to have to go again from the 2-yard line.
Now this is Pontiac, Michigan, despite the fact there are a lot of Steeler fans here. And even at the hotel last night, there was quite a greeting party for this Pittsburgh team as they arrived after practicing at Three Rivers earlier in the day. Sims. Touchdown, Detroit.
Get a feeling for the response on the two sidelines. This is the main man for Detroit. Get the ball to Sims. Look how well he works in behind the blocking of Thompson, but it's his acceleration, his cutting ability, his vision, and eventually his strength that got him across the goal line.
Eddie Murray's kick is through, and the Lions, impressively staying primarily on the ground, score on a 2-yard run by Sims. He caps an 83-yard opening drive in 11 plays. 7-0 Lions. Well, the Lions roar early. Sims, a 30-yard run, then the reverse by Nichols, the pass from Hipple to Chadwick, and then the 2-yard touchdown for Sims, who is also the cheerleader today. Even in the introduction of the starting lineups, he was out there really trying to get his team ready. He's a highly competitive, emotional athlete, as well as being extremely well-talented. Odom and Harris, two youngsters, rookies, back for Pittsburgh as Eddie Murray kicks it off, and Pittsburgh will have its first chance. It's the longest drive all season against that Steeler defense for a touchdown, 83 yards. Good hit by Murray. 1 yard deep. Here comes Harris. Got that Odom at the 10. Odom fumble. Who's got it? Pittsburgh out of that crowd of Honolulu Blue of Detroit. Reaching through was, well, it was Horace King who made the tackle, but the Steelers recovered the ball.
And a big, big break. It looked for a second that there was no chance that the Steelers could get that football. Literally a sea of Lion players around it. Good twisting hit there, but it's this shot by King right straight into the football that shook it loose. Now look at how many Lion players have a shot. Diving in, is that Merriweather? Mike Merriweather finally got his hands on the football?
Yep, he saved the day. Pittsburgh begins at the 17. Franco, is he? No, it's not Harris, it's Pollard. Well, we'll get it right. It's Abercrombie. So he starts in the backfield with Harris, and Abercrombie is rather rudely welcomed into the game. Cliff Stout, the quarterback for the Steelers. Walter Abercrombie at one running spot and the incomparable Harris at the other. Greg Garrity will open at one wide receiver spot, and Calvin Sweeney leads the Steelers with 32 catches. Benny Cunningham has 29, the tight end. Stout faces second and 11. Gets an opening at the 20 and down at the 24. It's interesting to note that Franco Harris has, in his last 2 years, the longest run is only 16 yards, so he's earned every inch as he goes after Jim Brown's mark. His blockers are Ted Peterson at left tackle from Eastern Illinois, Craig Wolfley from Syracuse, the center, the All-Pro Mike Webster, and on the right side, Rick Donnelly of North Carolina for the injured Steve Corson, and Larry Brown back in the lineup starting at right tackle, the Pro Bowler from Kansas.
Trent Jilkin spent some time in the hospital this week. They've got Larry back in here. Let's see how long he can play.
Third and four. Intercepted by the Lions. Fantetti on the carom. Greg Hawthorne, ball right through his arms and into that of the waiting linebacker Fantetti.
There should be a category of undeserved interceptions, at least as far as quarterbacks are concerned. Cliff Stout puts this one right in the arms of Greg Hawthorne, but you've got to credit Fantetti. Great ball reaction as he sees the ball bouncing out of Hawthorne's chest and simply dives in there and scoops it off the turf. Big turnover, good field position for Detroit.
Lions minus five this year while the Steelers are a plus eight. And nothing on that play.
Fumble.
Up by Dunn and
no.
Lambert. They say the ball was down. Let's go back to the takeaway ratio, turnover ratio. So critical. And of course, the Redskins have really flourished in that department, by far the best in the NFL. But the Steelers, a plus eight, and they have seven touchdowns on defense. The Lions are a minus five, but boy, they flirted with getting the ball from the time Pittsburgh took the kickoff. Almost had it on the tackle of the kickoff of the Steelers, and they get it on Fantetti's interception. Leading 7-0. We're in the first quarter. 7:50 remaining in the period. Time is called by the Pittsburgh Steelers. Unusual timeout, Merlin.
Must have some kind of problem down there. Lambert going to the sideline.
Well, we featured Billy Sims and Franco Harris on NFL 83, and we'll be watching them closely throughout the course of today's game, and we'll also feature them going into commercial, going all the way back, in some cases, to their childhood. Former Heisman winner at Oklahoma, Billy Sims, number 20, 3 years in the league, three times in the Pro Bowl. He is an exceptional athlete, and the Steelers, to the man, defensively acknowledging that he has some talents that very few have in this league. He enters the touchdown, 7-0 Detroit. Hipple in cover. And no, that'll be a sack. He was in the grasp and control of the tackler, and the Steelers have their first sack today, their 43rd of the year, as Harvey Clayton, a defensive back, made the hit.
This is the kind of situation that the Detroit Lions wanted to avoid. Long yardage. The Steelers put in their special defenses and special personnel swarming out there. Lambert up in front of Hipple. Clayton slipping in to get him. He could not see his receiver. Ulysses Norris was open, but he could not see over the top. Hipple not the biggest of quarterbacks.
Loss of about five. Lions third and 15 from the Pittsburgh 37. Shotgun first time for Hipple. He has the first down at the 20.
One nice thing about young quarterbacks, their legs aren't all messed up. They can still run. Hipple is averaging 4 points, 4 yards per carry on the season, and he is not afraid to run. A quick look at Hipple. Now watch Hipple. He's going to take this football in trouble, sprint out to his left. And when he sees that there is nowhere to go, he's simply going to break it up the side. Feels the pressure. Keith Willis right there actually cutting down Dunn on the inside, doing a good job of blocking for Hipple. But what a good job of getting outside and sprinting down the sideline. And you see him running past the yellow flag.
Holding also the call on the play, so five more yards are tacked on after Hipple ducked out of bounds inside the Pittsburgh 17. So the Lions leading 7-0 midway through this first quarter, and a chance to jump out with a big early lead against a tough Steeler defense.
This is a team that loves to get out in front early.
Sims almost fumbled the handoff and still makes yardage.
Oh,
he did a nervous juggling act.
One of the places I mentioned early that this Steeler defense is not a blitzing team. One of the places they do blitz is on first down, and they're basically run blitzes. They got great penetration. You see Merriweather all the way in, but Sims is so quick. He's able to just adjust himself and get his body around, jumps over the top, does a great job of saving what looked to be a broken play and getting some good yardage.
To the nine. And Sims, with all of his agility and great talents that way, unlike some of the scat backs, Chuck Noll last night, he compared him to Joe Washington, only said he also has the size and strength to overpower you.
Talking to Lambert, I talked to Lambert about Sims, and I said, you've watched him, you looked at the film, what do you think? He said, I can't believe this guy. He said he has all of this power, all this skill, and he's still fighting for every single yard he can get. He jumps in the air, leaps over the pile. He said, just absolute disregard for his body. Tremendous praise from Jack Lambert.
A man who knows about disregarding one's physical health. Dwayne Woodruff apparently okay, shaken up on that stop. It's 7-0 Detroit. Wherever you may be, thank you for sharing this Thanksgiving Day with us on NBC Sports. It's 7-0 Detroit.
Watch the tight ends. Norris here and McCall, number 81, coming in, sealing off. What a great job of blowing open a hole for Billy Sims.
The ball is at the 9-yard line, third, and a long two for Hipple. He brings in the wide receivers. The tight ends out, three wide receivers, and he'll work out of the shotgun. Complete. Chadwick was the closest lion, and Hipple hit the dust as Lambert came through on a blitz.
Pittsburgh Steelers deciding they're going to have to do something to shake the Lions early in this ball game. Have uncharacteristically uncorked a great deal of blitzing here. They come right after him, sit him down.
We have two outstanding place kickers in this game. Murray, one of those. He's missed only four times this year in 20 tries. And his counterpart, Gary Anderson, we'll get to him later. Also an outstanding year. This one will be a 27-yard attempt. And the Lions add three more. 5 minutes and 51 seconds remaining in the first quarter. The Lions turn the interception into a field goal and lead the Pittsburgh Steelers 10-0. Seat some 80,000. The Pontiac Silverdome. Jack Lambert, his sack, or at least the pressure on the quarterback, Hipple, forced an incomplete, a key play in that last drive. The Lions settle for three, 10-0. Harris and Odom are deep as Murray again kicks to Henry Odom. 10, 20, and to about the 27-yard line, and a flag is down. Steve Doig made the tackle, second-year man from New Hampshire for the Lions. And apparently the penalty against Pittsburgh, illegal use of the hands. So the Steelers will start deep in their own end. Let's check the Lions defense, and it's a restructured defense. Curtis Green. William Gay has moved from starting right end inside to left tackle. Doug English, a pro bowler at right tackle, and they made room for this youngster. We'll watch him, 66, Mike Cofer, rookie, Tennessee. Gary Cobb at one linebacker spot in the 4-3 alignment. Fantetti, the leading tackler for the Lions again. And Jimmy Williams, a number one draft pick a year ago. The deep four, Bobby Watkins, who leads the Lions with four interceptions. The other corner, Bruce McNorton, he has three steals. The safeties are Alvin Hall and William Graham. Steelers begin at their own 12-yard line. Abercrombie. A yard or two. Jimmy Williams and William Graham made the tackle, and that play just didn't seem to get off very well.
Certainly didn't. Good pressure initially, and the 4-3 defense that the Lions employ, if they can dominate on the line of scrimmage with that big defensive line, can really wreak havoc with you. Chuck Noll talking about how fortunate they were to have played a four-man line last week in Minnesota, and getting ready because of the short week, it helped them in their preparation. Hasn't helped them so far in the game, however.
I want to get back to that short week because it is an important part of this Thursday game. Abercrombie saw a brief daylight, but Gary Cobb, former University of Southern California Trojan, made the stop short of the first down. You had to prepare. You play on a Sunday, and then you have to go on the road for a Thursday game. What's it do to the Steelers?
Well, it was interesting. It certainly favors the home team because that extra travel is just an added problem. Chuck Noll was talking about practice. He said, in one day of practice, we had to do Thursday and Friday and Saturday practices all in one. He said, you just can't get ready for a game like this. You go with a short schedule and simplify things to get ready.
Third down and six. Lions use an extra defensive back. Stout in trouble. Intercepted by the Lions at the 24-yard line. Alvin Hall, his second of the year.
One of Cliff Stout's problems throughout this season is that he has sometimes thrown the ball to the men in the wrong colored uniform. Has 9 touchdowns, now 14 interceptions. Gets away from Cooper there and then fires the shot deep. But Alvin Hall had really done a brilliant job of reading Stout. Stout takes a little time to get rid of it. That's all Hall needed, to step in front of Sweeney and pull the interception down.
Sims and Thompson behind Hipple at the 23 of the Steelers. Sims on a delay. Look at the desire. He's all the way to the 12.
A little draw play. Not much of a play until Sims breaks it outside. Goes right through Robin Cole on the tackle attempt there. Gets away from Dunn and up in the air. Look at him fighting for that. That's the thing Jack Lambert was talking about. He said he fights for every single inch he can get.
Runs like a bucking Bronco. A man from Hooks, Texas, Billy Sims. And they're waiting for him this time, and maybe a loss of a yard. Robin Cole said, not 2 times in a row. Give me another chance. And Robin Cole. 53 yards already for Billy Sims. Lifts Stout. Been intercepted twice in this first quarter. One not his fault. 10-0 Lions. 3 minutes and 12 seconds left in this first quarter. Boy, if they score a touchdown here, the Steelers are really going to have to dig out of a deep hole.
They certainly are. They're already behind the eight ball a bit. Let's see if the Steeler defense can respond. Pressure defense, a big play defense. Norris working on two linebackers, Cole and Taves, 56 and 51, starts across and stumbles. They may have lost him there, and he's all by himself. Got to believe that somebody blew the coverage there, Dick.
Murray just hooks that one in, and the Detroit Lions here in the first quarter, one impressive 83-yard drive and 2 interceptions deep in Steeler territory, have led to 10 more points.
Whoa. Detroit fans arriving here, perhaps expecting to see the stumbling team that had played last week. The Lions are red hot.
17 big ones on the board for the Honolulu Blue and Silver. You're the answer, man. I just got the big question, though, for you. What, you know, a couple folks outside want to know, what kind of meat, turkey, do you like? They're getting ready for you.
I used to eat a whole turkey, not just part of the turkey.
Doesn't matter. Just serve it up.
That's right.
And for the Detroit Lions, they are serving rather painfully. 17-point early lead that the Steeler defense will find difficult to digest. That one was quick. Less than a minute and a half for Ulysses Norris to gather in that 13-yard pass after the interception by Alvin Hall. A blitzed out and the Steelers work to do, but plenty of time in which to get it done. 2 minutes and 44 seconds left in the first quarter. Lions trying to make it 500 on Thanksgiving Day. Screen to the right, Abercrombie. Has a first down at the 33-yard line. Bobby Watkins made the tackle. Good block by Rick Donnelly of the Steelers.
Donnelly and Webster both out in front of that little screen. And that play, of course, designed to, again, to take advantage of the reactions of a good defense. They're faking the little screen out to the left and then flip it right back on the right side. You see Donnelly, who's already made his block here. Actually, the man gets off the block right there. It's Cobb, but Donnelly had slowed him up enough to keep him out. Take it back. That was Webster's block there, and Donnelly's downfield.
From the 34. The incomplete to Calvin Sweeney. Bruce McNorton from Georgetown of Kentucky on the coverage.
That's the kind of situation, second long, third long, that you love to get into if you've got a good pass-rushing defensive line. And this Detroit defensive line gets a great many sacks. They don't have the number of sacks that Pittsburgh does as a team, but as a defensive line, they have virtually all of their 31 sacks.
The All-Pro Mike Webster takes the Steelers out of the huddle. Second and 10. Stout had unload, and it's incomplete on the sidelines. As the Lions, mixing it up, brought two men right up over the center, Mike Webster.
Now, we mentioned that Lions really don't do that much blitzing, and they've changed their character a little bit today. They came right after him on that play, right up the gut, able to get William Gay sprung into there. He was the guy that was sitting right on top of Stout, forced Stout to throw early, looking at the touchdown and interception records of quarterback there.
Stout a minus four this year, despite the fact his team is 9-3. Third and 10. Stout looking for a block, and he gets one, and a first down out at the 49-yard line. And remember, Stout is the top running quarterback, unfortunately for the Steelers, sometimes for his own life, but nevertheless leads all NFL quarterbacks with 368 yards running this year.
15 yards on that play, and the block from number 32, Franco Harris, down there in front of him, clearing the way.
As it developed, didn't appear he had enough room, but Harris's block gave him that opening.
You'll feel him coming downfield here. Couldn't find the open receiver. There's Franco right there. Good block. Bobby Watkins on the side there.
At midfield, first down Pittsburgh, trailing 17-0. Abercrombie gets a block. 45, 40, and a first down at the Lions 38 before Bruce McNorton can make the tackle for the Lions along with Alvin Hall. There's some of the black and gold from Pittsburgh cheering their team.
Just a tremendous block on that play from number 55, Rick Donnelly, who cut underneath. It looked like he took down two, maybe even three of the Lions. Abercrombie is their big play man. He likes to break it deep. A little bit of the action taking place. There's number 55 right at the bottom of your screen. Look at him, stacked him up, had two good shots right there to clear the way.
Frank Pollard, his first carry. And he had a knee down, whistled down at about the 33-yard line. Pollard has had a good year. He's quietly picked up 413 yards and a good rushing average, 4.3.
In fact, his rushing average, except for Stout's average, the best on the team, certainly the best of any of the running backs.
Bill Gay, 79, in on the tackle.
Originally drafted as a tight end by Denver, if you can believe it. And seeing him in the locker room, he is huge. Of course, has gone to the weights with his new responsibility as a defensive lineman.
Second down between 5 and 6. Pollard wrapped up by 23 Maurice Harvey, veteran safety, short of the first down, just inside the line 30, where it'll be third down and less than two.
With Dan Wagoner out, Maurice Harvey brought him in from Denver. Has done a good job. You'll get a feeling for being right in the middle of the ball game with this one. A finesse pass. Look how softly Stout lofts this one over the top. Now watch this connection with Maurice Harvey and Frank Pollard. A good one-on-one tackle.
Big down for the Steelers, third and short. And it's Franco picking the hole and a first down.
Fumble.
Yes, it is a fumble, and who's got it? The Lions do, unless it was whistled dead.
Now they're saying he was down. I don't know. It looked to me like that ball was bouncing around in there.
Gary Cobb says, I've got the pumpkin.
I think we better take a look at that one. It certainly seemed to me that ball was out early, but maybe a knee was down before it came loose.
First down.
Said the ball was shaken loose by contact. Harris just shaking here. Look how he shakes and finally feels an opening and breaks up. Let's see if we can spot the football. It'll pop. There it is, right there. Well, absolutely no way to tell where Franco's knees were. He was in the middle of that mass.
And with that play, the Steelers have a first down at the Lion 26, the end of the first quarter. And here in the Silver Dome, the partisan Lion fans have celebrated an early lead.
Section 1-3.
Well, a happy holiday. Take time to love your friends and your family. Walter Abercrombie.
Ralph Lillian over working on his knee just a minute ago, Dick. They're a little concerned. He's left the ball game, and of course, that's not a good sign. He is the big play man for Pittsburgh. They miss his speed and explosiveness if he's not in there.
Steelers open the second quarter trailing Detroit 17-0. A first down at the Lions 26. Frank Pollard backdoors his way for three or four. Williams and Cobb, the two outside linebackers for the Lions, made the tackle. Official statistics in the first quarter, Merlin.
Certainly stats will favor the Lions there. Biggest stat, time of possession. Yardage, very big in favor of the Lions, 125 to 65. Steelers would very much like to get those balanced out a little bit. Biggest stat they'd like to balance is the one on the scoreboard.
And the turnovers, 2-0 in that first quarter that led to the Lions. And they come with a blitz. Jimmy Williams, number one pick of the Lions last year from Nebraska, native of Washington, D.C., and he came through cleanly.
Jimmy Williams. Well, a little bit of a changeup. Certainly the Cliff Stout surprised. Have not seen that many blitzes from Detroit. Situation like this, and here he comes. Nobody even there to look at him to help Stout in the backfield. He's all by himself. From the right side of your picture, number 59. Look how quickly. Good anticipation. Look how quickly he's in on top of Stout. No chance for the quarterback.
The 30th sack this year for the Lion defense. Third down about 14. Stout in trouble. There's a man wide open, Calvin Sweeney, but he's hit short of the first down. Gary Cobb at the Lion 22 along with Roosevelt Barnes. 9 yards on the play.
A good decision by Stout, who could have run for fair yardage on that play. And Stout is still on the ground. He's holding his knee. That's certainly not a situation that Pittsburgh fans will relish at all, and he is hurt. He is really hurt.
Mike Cofer, the rookie we talked about from Tennessee, was applying the pressure. Gary Anderson will try a 39-yard field goal. Craig Colquitt to hold. 20 of the last 22 for Anderson. And that one is right down the center. In his young career, he's made 33 of 39. He might just have the classic style. It's 17-3, Detroit. Cliff Stout shaken by that last tackle that he appears to be okay, but in case Mark Malone is tuning up on the sidelines and Bradshaw out, but there's no doubt that Stout can pull it out.
Well, they'd love to keep Stout in there. Malone has not taken a single snap during this NFL season.
Anderson, he puts it in the end zone again, and Jenkins won't run that one up.
Well, that's
back at the 20. It's an interesting note that Stout is the only quarterback in the AFC to take every snap this year, and I think Bartkowski is the only
Atlanta.
Other.
Yes, the only two quarterbacks that have gone through this entire season without going to the sideline. Of course, this has been a year for quarterbacks in and quarterbacks out. Tremendous number of starting quarterbacks injured or replaced during this season. Stout has yet to finish a full season as a starter. I think this is, what, his 14th game as a starter, Dick?
That's right, and he's been around a considerable amount of time.
He sure has.
Well, story the fact he made the pension without ever playing a down. So the Lions leading 17-3 have it again. Early second quarter, 13 minutes left in the half. They call for Thompson, who burrows for four.
Ted Marchibroda has done a good job of designing this game plan for today, and obviously knowing how strongly this Steeler defense was going to focus on Sims, has been able to use the deception of Sims outside and hand the ball to Thompson back inside for some good gains.
There's Marchibroda, the former Colts head coach.
Saw his game plan there in his left hand.
Sims ran right into the arms of Mike Merriweather and Gary Dunn.
In talking to Ted Marchibroda yesterday, he was giving me some information on the Steeler defense and said he said the thing that impresses me every time I watch them play is how well prepared they are and the fact that they never quit. They just keep coming. He said it's like they're kind of a throwback. They have the character of a team out of the 60s or the 70s.
Jack Lambert has not gotten up after that last tackle. There's the man who has led the Steelers in tackles for 10 straight years, counting this one. 8 straight years All-Pro. Needless to say, that could be critical.
Let's see what happened on this play. Lambert slipping a block as he does so well. Starts, looks like he had his... Yeah, let's see what he does after he goes down.
Looks like Ron Johnson might have hit him in the back of that right knee. Now, Lambert being attended. We have a timeout here at the Silver Dome. 12 minutes, 12 seconds left in the first half. Working on Jack Lambert, the head trainer, Ralph Berlin.
I'll tell you, that trainer becomes a more and more important man on the team this time of the year.
Hipple, third and five at his 25. Uh-oh! Flag is down. I wonder if someone might have touched that ball defensively as it was being snapped. The flag went down. There
ball
might have
start,
been...
right guard offense, right guard.
Well, that whistles it dead. So apparently the right guard, maybe he kicked it as he pulled away from the line too soon. Let's see.
Maybe we'll go back and look at it. But what a big break on that play for the Lions. And that ball is out and loose had the right guard not been moving. Ball just laid on the center, late on the snap. No, nobody touched it, Dick. He just panicked when he realized he was late and snapped it clear. Wonder what, let's see what Hipple says when that ball goes over his head. Boy, I'll tell you, that's an embarrassing moment. And then he's not, doesn't have a chance at it right here. First man down there, Keith Gary, number 93. Keith Willis, number 93.
Center Steve Mott, the rookie from Alabama. Talk about him after this play. It's now third and 10 for Hipple. Under a blitz. Going deep for Sims. And what an effort, and a flag goes down. Merriweather thought that he had gone for the ball, but I believe they'll call interference.
Well, that's one that can be debated. If you're a defensive player, you say Merriweather was robbed. If you're an offensive receiver, you say that's a great call.
Pass interference, number 57 defense, first down.
And we can take another look at that play and get a little insight into what actually did happen. Ball a little bit late getting into the air. Tremendous pressure on Hipple. It's right at the end there, and there was indeed contact before the ball had arrived. Now, the only way that Merriweather can get away with that is if he's making a legitimate attempt at the ball, and I think you could make a pretty good case for that. Now, let's go back and watch Hipple. Watch the blow he takes on the outside. Harvey Clayton, number 33 on the blitz, drops him heavy.
Well, it's a first down on the penalty. Lions at the 48 of the Steelers. Thompson has a good hole. 225-pounder hit by Ron Johnson at the 43-yard line. Today's game is brought to you by Chevrolet, official U.S. cars and trucks of the 14th Olympic Winter Games. Chevrolet and you taking charge. By the Ask For Motor Oil, Pennzoil, protection worth asking for. And by Sears, where you'll find great values. There's more for your life at Sears. Second down, Thompson again, pulling his way to a first down at the 35. Ron Johnson again, along with Mel Blunt and Dwayne Woodruff. Bring him down.
Dick, toward the end of a season, very often injuries force you to go to the bench. You've got to pull somebody off, pull somebody out of there, dust them off, and say, hey, the job is yours. You've got to pull for us. And that's what's happened today. Vince Thompson has come on and just done a fine job on the other sideline. Someone that the Steelers don't want to do without. Abercrombie's not expected now to come back into this game at all.
See the ice pack on the left knee. Paul Scansey is also out for Pittsburgh. Thompson gets about five more down to the 28 before Donnie Schell can make the hit. Apparently Scansey suffered head injury on the opening kickoff, and while he's okay, will not be allowed to return. So Lambert for the Steelers has come back in. But other than that, the news not good on the scoreboard nor the sidelines for Chuck Knoll.
Detroit Lions signaler plays into the ball game. They use number two quarterback. Scansey still got a bit of a vacant look in his eyes on that sideline over there. Usually pretty protective of a young man who has his bell rung that way.
Second and four. Sims, and he's greeted by Robin Cole. Old first round pick from New Mexico for the Steelers. He'll bring up third down and about four for the Lions.
Even on a bad play, and that certainly was not a good play by Detroit standards in this ball game, you get an idea of the quickness of Billy Sims. He just exploded back inside. Robin Cole strong enough in the hands and arms to pull him down.
He has an interesting superstition, Sims. He still wears his high school jersey under his game uniform now as a pro.
I hope they wash it every week.
What a catch by Jeff Chadwick, popped by Ron Johnson, and the youngster hangs onto the ball, even though he was shaken on that tackle.
Part of the Pittsburgh philosophy of defense, don't let them get deep. If they catch it in front of you, come up and knock the ball loose or make them sorry they caught it. And boy, that's a whiplash if you ever saw one. Young Jeff Chadwick getting the benefit of a real shot by Ron Johnson, number 29.
Chadwick, a standing ovation from the near side fans as he came off the field.
He earned it.
You bet. First down at the 24. Veteran Freddie Scott has replaced Chadwick. Sims runs into his own blocker. There was a nice hole for Sims on the inside, but in trying to make his cut, ran right up the back of Thompson. Whoops.
On the tackle for Pittsburgh, John.
Really very emotional in there. Dietrich, number 72, pulling across from his tackle position on the far side, does not get far enough in front there, and Billy Sims runs right smack into him. That little delay allowed the Steelers to come in and just swarm all over him.
Show you the power of Sims. Dietrich gained 3 yards on the play.
He's got a big bruise, too, I'll tell you that.
Plenty of time for Hippo. Wide open is Norris. And the tight end is to the 4-yard line.
Yards on the pickup to Norris. Reese McCall had gone deep after coming in motion. You'll see him come across behind and then come down in motion, and Hipple waited until Norris cleared across underneath the linebacker. Mike Merriweather, number 57, the man who was right there. There's Reese McCall. You see him tap the quarterback to tell him his bye. Now look how deep he gets. Pulls the defense deep. Allows the crossing pattern to Norris underneath. Big play. First and goal.
This one started back at the 20-yard line for the Lions. They were aided by an interference call, and Hipple's got him going for more. Sims.
Bumble.
Nope. Stretches forward to the four, hung onto the ball. And even when he was totally wrapped up, he was able to lean forward for a yard after he appeared he'd lose a couple.
Looked like that ball was loose momentarily. Kept his hands on it. Reese McCall, what a big tight end he is, and good speed downfield. Of course, that's one of the philosophies you try and use against the Steelers, knowing that they believe in staying deep with those defensive backs. You try and push them as deep as you can get them and then hit them underneath.
Trying to add to their 17-3 lead, the Lions. Second and goal, Hipple. Norris is wide open.
The Detroit Lions traded Dave Hill was that they believed that Ulysses Norris was going to be a real star for the Detroit Lions. He's really been a star today, Dick.
Second touchdown, this one for 4 yards as Murray tries the point after. And the Lions build their lead to 24-3. An impressive 80-yard drive. As Detroit's offense seemingly doing everything right, and Norris has been wide open all day.
This is come to run time. Hipple comes outside, not going to make it running the ball. He certainly will make it throwing the ball.
Who is that Dexter Manley look-alike?
Well, he certainly hit it right on the head early. In this ball game, the Lions have been awesome.
80 yards, 11 plays, helped out by the interference call, and they lead 24-3. Murray,
sending it to Tim Harris. And a young man from Washington State is dropped at the 26-yard line by Robbie Martin. Cliff Stout brings his team on the field. Apparently Stout okay. He was telling you that he remembers coming up here to watch you play.
1975, well, he didn't really come to watch me. He came to watch Ron Jaworski, who had, of course, played at Youngstown, where Stout eventually went to school. And Stout, of course, was in the process of breaking some of Jaworski's records at the time. That was a happy day for the Rams, a winning day. Stout would like to get out there with a winning score himself, but he's going to have to throw the ball to do it.
Deflected and intercepted by the... No, he did not hang on. He did not hang on. Bruce McNorton had it three or four times.
Oh, he showed great leaping ability. Jump up in front of that one.
Tremendous leap and great hand-eye coordination and concentration as he batted that ball around and never lost track of it. Just a quick slant play. Good bat right there by Williams, I believe, the linebacker. Look at him going up after that football. And, oh, it just wouldn't stay in his hands. Big break for the Steelers, but they're still second and 10. And look out for the rush on this one. They're coming full bore.
6 minutes left in the first half, 24-3, Detroit. And Stout says, hey, stay back and help me out. Pollard and Franco, and it's Franco. Very little to the 28. Doug English, former All-American at Texas, making the stop.
Doug English, certainly one of the exciting tackles in the NFL. Quick look inside, number 79, Brown. Look at him right here in the middle of your picture, doing a great job working first on the tackle and then outside on Cobb, number 53. They're concerned about Brown. Ellen, oh, they don't want to see that. That's Kofor.
Ted Peterson.
Oh, excuse me. I'm looking at the number, not the man. Ted Peterson. With all the injuries that have been sustained by this Pittsburgh offensive line, they certainly do not want to see anyone else go down. Last week, Mike Webster came out of the hospital just in time for the game, and Chuck Knoll wasn't going to let him play. And Webster said, look, I didn't get out of the hospital to sit on the bench, played the whole game. This week, Tunch Ilkin has been in the hospital with a viral infection. They got him out, brought him in, and boy, when it rains, it pours. Steve Corson didn't even make the trip, starting guard normally, and of course, Peterson plays right next to him.
Emil Boris from Pitt comes in at the tackle spot. Stout, third and seven. Finds the open man, Greg Garrity, the rookie from Penn State, has a first down at the 40, 11-yard play. A reminder that coming up as we start to celebrate a long weekend of sports on NBC, we're calling this Sports Week 83, starting today. Tomorrow night, of course, we have the fight, but on Sunday it'll be completed with our NFL action, 83, NFL 83 at 12:30. Those are the early games, and one of the big games featured will be the Buffalo Bills and Los Angeles Rams, two teams in the thick of the fight for a playoff spot. So be with us on Sunday for more of the best of the NFL. Stout on first down hits Franco, who's tackled immediately by Fantetti at the 47-yard line. Fantetti from the University of Wyoming, and Monty Clark refers to him as a deluxe hitter.
He certainly is that. Franco, good pass receiver. He worked on his hands over the years back early in the season, led the Steelers as a receiver as well as a runner. It's his 27th reception of the year.
And 299 in his career. One more for the 300 mark. Second and three.
Gary Cobb sacks Stout. Stout felt the pressure from the left, had no idea that Cobb was coming from the other side. A flag is down, and so is Stout, who gets up slowly.
Sometimes when the linebackers arrive that quickly, they've jumped the gun just a bit to get there. Man, that Williams was jumping. Oh, they're going to call motion. Franco coming up to try and pick off Williams on this play, and look at that, right over the top. Stout has to be able to look past the rush. But boy, I'll tell you, that's difficult when you've got two linebackers breathing down your throat.
Must have looked like two tidal waves coming in on him. That Williams flying from one side and Cobb the other.
Ed Beard, defensive coordinator for the Lions, changing it up today. He's got them flying.
Third and 11 from the 40.
needs something big and doesn't get it. Greg Garrity wanted interference down at the line 40. Bobby Watkins, the defender, and the Steelers bring on the punting team.
I believe this is the first punt of the day. They've turned it over. They've had their problems. They'll finally kick it away, and this has not been a good first half for the Pittsburgh Steelers.
And along with the score, 24-3 Detroit, the injuries that the Steelers are going to have to absorb, and of course the fear of how serious those hurts might be in affecting the run toward the playoffs. Four games to go. We have an interesting statistic. In first place on Thanksgiving, how successful are you at the end of the regular season and remaining in first? Oops, the Lions, and there's contact by Rick Kane. A bit too eager. We'll see if he was drawn off.
Doesn't really matter. Even if it is a penalty, it won't be enough for the first down. They'll have to kick
it
away.
False start, 44 offense.
So everything going wrong for the Steelers. Odom pulled him offside.
Dick, I talked to Ahmad Rashad, and of course Ahmad played in a head-to-head confrontation with these Lions many times over the years, and he said one thing you don't want to do is get behind to them early at home. He said they just have the ability then to stretch out and get tougher, and he said the crowd really becomes a factor in a ball game because they are so loud.
And in turn, if they don't do well because of some losing years, they can turn on the home team. So the Steelers have walked into the toughest possible Lions den. Colquitt did a good job of catching the ball, but then scuffs one off to the left. It'll go out of bounds. Lions are going to get the ball around the 35.
Colquitt angry. Difficulty sliding over. Has to pick that one off in the air. And of course, when you break the rhythm of a kicker, you've caused him to get out of his normal frame, and he's not happy with himself. But believe me, it's not all his fault.
32-yard punt, and the Lions leading big will have the ball again. Good field position at their 33. Steelers top speed back, Walter Abercrombie. That left knee wrapped is out for the rest of this game. Eric Kippel has the Lions in front, 24-3. Less than 4 minutes left. First half, the Lions have run on every first down. They do it again. That's 16 times out of 16 the Lions have run on first down. Merlin, you said the key to the game would be the running game and stopping Billy Sims. And so far, Steelers have not done that.
They certainly have not done it. In fact, the average is 4.7 on first downs, but perhaps a little change here as they do a good job of stuffing him on that particular play. And pressure right now on the Pittsburgh defense. They've got to get a big play going. And if it's going to happen, it probably will be from this man, Jack Lambert, who is their leader.
First on Thanksgiving Day the last 12 years, you finish first 83% of the time. Only one on the average per year doesn't make it. Sims getting out to about the 37-yard line. Wonder that's important enough, kind of like the 4th of July in baseball in first place. Thanksgiving Day usually marks the three-quarter mark, four games to go. And in the past, only 12 times out of a possible 72 has a team in first place on Thanksgiving not been first at the end of the season. So whether you're rooting for your club in first or trying to get into first, that's what history has dealt. Five. Flags down. Chadwick knocked out of bounds immediately. Is short of the first down at the 41, but let's check the penalty.
It appeared that Keith Willis, the left end, had gotten off to an early start for a moment. I thought they were going to ignore it, but let's see if that is indeed it.
It's against the Steelers, offside.
A lot of times the defensive ends can make a slight move toward the ball without going over, but apparently put his head over.
Well, the Pittsburghs had the line short of the first down. Detroit would have had to punt the ball, but instead that penalty will make it very close to a first down.
And you can understand the eagerness of a young man like a Keith Willis, who's had such an outstanding year. He just wants to get in there and do his job. And in the process, trying to listen to that snap count, actually listened a little too well. He's got to watch that football out of the corner of his eye, Dick.
First down.
Interior lineman defense, offside, first down.
Well, almost interior lineman. The official who called it was on the far side, and he's looking across and saw a head go across the line. That head belonged to Keith Willis, number 93.
Well, what a pick Willis was. A free agent out of Northeastern in Boston, and has 13 sacks this year for Pittsburgh. 395! 395! Billy Sims running again on first down. And out across the 46-yard line before David Little, number 50, to make the tackle.
We had mentioned James Jones, and that is not good news. You see Pete going off on the back of that wagon, and the ice on the foot. A lot of foot injuries, Dick. Awful lot of foot and arch injuries, and certainly many of them coming on the artificial turf. But when you're already hurt in your offensive line, that's the last thing you want to look at.
There's the two-minute timeout on this Thanksgiving Day. The Lions are the ones feasting so far, 24-3 over Pittsburgh. Gary Kippel takes the offense back on the field. Looks a little different, doesn't
he? Yes, he does. I got a chance to talk to him yesterday, and I was trying to figure it out. He said, shaved the mustache off. Things were not going well. He needed a change, so about Halloween time, he took the mustache off. Of course, there's the man who backs him up. He also signals in the plays, Derek, when he's out on the field.
And Mike McCurick, the third-string quarterback. Second down and about six, and Kippel protects the ball as he goes down at the 39. Lambert, his second sack today. And for the Steelers, who are tied with the Raiders for first place in the American Conference starting this week, that's their 44th of the year.
One of the most respected players in the NFL, number 58, Jack Lambert. And look how quickly he slides to the outside. He and Merriweather both in on top of Hipple, who has no chance. Three linebackers in the blitz. The Steelers say, hey, we got to make the big plays. And I said it earlier, if they're going to get the big plays, often they come from Lambert, and he responds instantly.
He's the leader. Third down and a long 13. Good protection, and now it breaks down, and another sack for the Steelers. There may
be
a fumble, and the Steelers have it. 92, Keith Gary came up with the ball, and it is a Pittsburgh fumble recovery.
Had been running the blitz. They came back with just a simple four-man rush. Their two young defensive ends bowling from the outside. Gary from the right, Willis from the left. Gary working right there. Well, he's getting buried right there, but he gets up soon enough to see the football loose. Look at him reaching in there, just like digging it out.
I bet he's tough on Easter.
I bet he is.
So the turnover the Steelers needed desperately, trailing 24-3, a minute 20 seconds left in this first half, and Pollard tripped up by William Graham, the strong safety from Texas. There's Graham, starter as a rookie last year.
Young man who's not afraid to come up and hit you, the number two tackler for this Detroit team, and did a good job right there. Stout, upset about something.
Clock is stopped with 1:02 left, and now they wind it up. NFL 83. They join us at halftime. Well, that was too high for Paris and too short for Hawthorne, and a flag is down.
Well, I'm afraid there's going to be a holding call on that one. When you've had to revamp your offensive line as thoroughly as Chuck Knoll and his staff have had to work on it, they really have some problems in there. We've got some people who just aren't used to being in that ball game very much.
Eugene Barth marches off a 10 out to the 42.
55 offense, holding, still second down.
Watching the right-hand corner of your screen, you see William Gay, 79. And that man kind of dragging along behind is number 55, Rick Donnelly, who doing everything he could to keep him off the quarterback, using the hands in the process.
52 seconds left in the half, 24-3, Detroit leads. Down the middle to Cunningham, and too tall for the tight end. Pittsburgh has really struggled offensively in this half.
They certainly have, and they have not played outstanding offense over the past few weeks. In fact, the running game, which usually has banked on Franco Harris, has not been able to generate. Harris himself only over 200 yards, 205 yards the last four games, averaging 3.2. Not the kind of productivity we're used to seeing from him. And Stout is not the kind of quarterback who can really bring you from behind with a passing game.
Third and 20. By Garrity down at the 22 and a timeout by Stout. That's going to be a first down if it counts. Did Stout stop shy of the line of scrimmage?
I think he did.
Apparently so. Boy, that took some presence, didn't it?
He made a smart play. It appeared that he was going to run. He attacked the line of scrimmage here and then backs off and throws a little dying quail. Now it dies right in the hands of Garrity, and that's a big play.
It's inside the line 22 and a first down on third and 20. He picks up 21. 36 seconds left in the half.
Look at Noel. You don't have to explain what he's feeling.
No, nor do you have to register the worry on Tom Moore's face. He's the offensive coordinator, deeply concerned about the injuries and the ineffectiveness of the offense so far.
36 seconds left in the half. Steelers desperate for a score before the half. Won't get it that way as Calvin Sweeney. Well covered. It was out of his reach anyway as Graham and Hall on the coverage.
Detroit Lions, one of the most active defensive lines in running stunts. They are busy attacking that Steeler offense with them. We'll try and get a few of them for you later in the ball game.
I wonder why you were wiping your chin. You do salivate every time you see those defensive
stunts. Well, I'll tell you, the games that were most fun for me were games when you had a team down, you knew they had to throw the football, and you just leaned out and went after the quarterback, and that's what's happening right now on the field.
Yeah, they're not going to get in the end zone on that play. Two-yard gain as they hit Cunningham, the tight end, and he was hit by Bobby Watkins. Timeout with... Well, the clock is still running. They didn't take the time.
17-16 and moving it on down.
Remember, the Steelers called a timeout back in the first quarter when they were on defense, so they have only one timeout left.
Oh!
Intercepted by Bruce McNorton, and so goes the Steelers' rep.
Cliff Stout just saying, what in the world going on here? Looked like Calvin Sweeney may have quit on the pattern. Pattern kind of thrown off. Stout a little late getting the ball off. And Stout over there to ask him, hey, why didn't you follow through on the pattern? Stout is looking at the receiver who's coming across, and Sweeney stopped. Ball, of course, thrown in front of him, and no chance. Good play by McNorton to get it, but they were well within range of a field goal. At least they could have had the 3 points or a shot at it.
A dismal Pittsburgh first half about to end. 5 seconds remaining, and the Lions... In contrast, playing flawlessly.
Oh, they're taking the football away, aren't they? Well, we talked about defensive tradition. The Lions have taken it beyond tradition today.
They have growled and lead 24-3 at the end of the first half here at the sold-out Pontiac Silverdome. The score at the intermission, the Lions 24, the Steelers 3.
Really had to do some juggling. Ted Peterson been lost for the day. Looks like Boris is in his place. Rick Donnelly at the right guard and place of Corson. And Larry Brown enjoying his first playing time in many, many weeks.
For 7 weeks with a leg injury. Number 79 on this side of the line.
Franco, been a quiet Thanksgiving for the All-Pro. Jimmy Williams made the tackle. Harris had only 14 yards rushing in the first half.
Of course, the key to good play on the inside, line blocking. Larry Brown, number 79, has got to be tired. He has not been able to practice a great deal. Working on Curtis Green, 62, certainly did a good job of keeping his man out of the tackle, but not a great deal of yardage on the play. Third and about 3 yards to go for the Steelers.
Hawthorne to the far side with Sweeney and Garrity to the near side for Stout on third down and about 3.5. He throws it away.
the Steelers unable to move the ball again against this tough Detroit defense. On comes Colquitt.
Of course, you can't just run block in this league. You've got to pass block. Curtis Green doing a little flip on Larry Brown and gets away from Brown, but that's really not Brown's fault. That's supposed to be a setup in the pocket. Stout ran out of there on his own and left his protection. Of course, when you do that, you're on your own.
Robbie Martin, a former Steeler. He was drafted out of Cal Poly San Luis Obispo by Pittsburgh. Short kick, that'll be returned. 31-yard line, 35, 40. And Martin struggles to the 48. Colquitt can't be happy with that one. He hit a line drive that gave Martin plenty of time. 42 yards and a 23-yard return. Now the Lions will get the ball the first time almost at midfield.
Lions first and 10 after the 48.
Reintroduce the Lions for you. Nichols and Chadwick are the wide receivers. Norris with a couple touchdown catches, the tight end. Billy Sims, the only running back behind Hipple. And it's Sims on first down. Breaks a tackle and ducks into the Pittsburgh 45. A gain of almost 7. Dwayne Woodruff made the stop.
The Lions are no dummies. They come right back with what's been working. Hand the ball to number 20. It'll let him do some work for us. Sims is not disappointing. Gets outside. Look how he cut inside of Mike Merriweather. Boy, the ability to see the holes, vision, and then the ability to hit those holes and accelerate is what makes a great back. Sims has all of that, the tenacity, the aggressiveness to go with it.
Right into the face of Hipple. And Thompson greeted by David Little and Jack Lambert. As they were ready for that call, no gain.
Little in place of Lauren Taves, who must be on the sideline. There's Jack Lambert, emotional leader of this team. Look how quickly he eludes the block on the inside. He's a tough, tough man. He's at the bottom of that stack. Oof.
You forget that Lambert, by linebacker standards, is not a huge man. He's only 220 pounds. Many men playing that position 15, 20 pounds heavier. Third and short, a mix up there. The Lions will have to punt. They haven't had to punt the entire game.
Dick, what's interesting, if you look at the defensive statistics for Pittsburgh, Lambert started this game with 115 tackles. The number two tackler, Mike Merriweather, 68 tackles. It gives you an idea of the number of plays that Lambert winds up at the bottom of.
Rookie from Arizona State, Michael Black. He had his problems at Green Bay against the Packers last week. He fumbled a couple of snaps. He said, I've never kicked in cold weather before. I was always to Arizona State, warm weather, kicking indoors here in Pontiac. He said, I just misjudged how cold my hands were. Brian Hinkle close to the block. Woods returns it and steps out of bounds at the 17-yard line. So Pittsburgh, trailing by 3 touchdowns, will have the ball deep in its own end. 32-yard punt, 5-yard return. It's been all Lions so far.
Did we ever get a final report
the Steelers,
on Peterson?
The Steelers, winning 7 in a row. We're going to check on the report on Peterson. And then lost to the Viking last Sunday. Pittsburgh has never given up more than 28 points all year. Gave up 24 in the first half to the Lions. Pollard. And he's hit hard at the 23-yard line. Mike Cooper, 66, made the tackle. And Merlin went down by 3 touchdowns. The Steelers came out on their first possession. Second half, tried to run the ball, couldn't move it. Will they change their strategy?
I'm sure Chuck Noll would like to. But I don't know that he has the horsepower over there right now to do it, Dick. He's got the revamped offensive line with two of his starters out. Abercrombie, his big play man, is on the bench. I think they're going to have to. I don't think they have any choice.
Come with a blitz. Stout. Nice play by 29, Bruce McNorton. Laid off the receiver. And he saw the ball thrown and made his quick move and broke up the pass.
Ball reaction. Defensive backs conscious of the quarterback, conscious of the time when he starts the throwing action. Take a look quickly at Stout going back. He's going to have a good chance here to get the ball in the air, but the defensive back's just too quick. Give him no chance on this one. Dive across in front, swap that ball away. That's good reaction by the defensive back. Gordon.
Third and five. And Sweeney, no good. He was out of bounds is the ruling, and the Steelers don't like that. So they'll have to punt it away.
Very quickly, got a feeling of the frustration that has permeated the Pittsburgh sideline throughout this day. They just can't seem to do things right. Stout with three interceptions on the day, trying to get the ball in the air, almost intercepted on the play before this one, and receiver Sweeney stepping out of bounds. 1 foot down inbounds, but simply put the other one outside.
Robbie Martin back at the Lion 33. A snap from Webster to Colquitt. That was Emil Boris with a snap. Martin at the 25. And the man who was the fifth round draft pick of the Steelers, make that fourth round pick in 81, returns at 10 yards. Detroit's ball, big lead. They have it at the 35. Been a tough game for the Steelers in more ways than one. Peterson out with an ankle, Scancy a concussion, Abercrombie with a knee, all of them not returning for Pittsburgh. Alvin Hall is out for the Lions. Billy Sims crunched at the 36-yard line after a gain of a yard, and another Steeler is down.
Keith Willis on the ground, and that young man who's had such a sparkling season, leading the Steelers in sacks, indeed one of the leading sackers in the league. And boy, this has been a brutal day for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Ralph Berlin, who's already been busy in the training room, got to wonder what's hit him.
Willis, the top pass rusher for the Steelers, 13 sacks, and the pain on the field and the pain on the expression of the head coach.
Dick, we talked last week about what you need to win in the playoffs, and I think the first priority is you've got to be healthy going into the playoffs. And just looking at the injury list, got to be a little scary for these Pittsburgh Steelers.
They work on the lower right extremity of Willis. Well, our big weekend of sports on NBC continues, as you saw, the fight doctor, Larry Holmes and Marvis Frazier. Between them, 54 fights, no defeats. Larry Holmes, 44-0, heavyweight champion. He said that if Marvis Frazier beats him, he doesn't care what the WBC says, he'll hand deliver his heavyweight championship belt. We'll also have one of the outstanding, exciting fighters in the world, Boom Boom Mancini, on the card. That's all tomorrow night, 9 o'clock Eastern time, live prime time, 6 o'clock in the West. And Willis limping off.
Talk about delivering a championship. You think Jim Brown will come and take his belt off and hand it to Franco?
You know, I did a little detective work this week. Do you mind if I share what I saw down in the basement of your house?
No, that's all right. Go ahead.
I saw Deacon and Lamar and you and Rosie working the front four planning the comeback.
We're looking at some film. That's all black and white film, Dick, but it's good film.
So watch out, Jim Brown. Hipple to Norris, and a flag is down at the 42-yard line as Norris makes the catch. Oh, he has been left alone today. This one apparently is going to go against Norris for a push. So the receiver, working his way open, used his hands illegally.
Officials much more conscious, it seems, in this day and age of the way the offense has learned to manipulate the defense. And with the rules so heavily in favor of the offense, you see the bump right there as Norris simply drove his shoulder into Mike Merriweather, number 57, pushed him off, got over, made the catch, but they're not going to let it stand.
Only the second line penalty. It'll bring up second down and about 19. Norris from Georgia. Monty Clark is from Kingsburg, California.
Dick, this is the kind of situation that Pittsburgh has capitalized on all year. Long yardage situations. They get the pressure on the quarterback and then get the takeaway.
They need that now. Hipple rolling away from that pressure. And misfires on the sidelines. Norris and Nichols, two receivers, were there together.
Questionable decision on Hipple's part. Receiver covered. He could have picked up an easy 8 or 10 yards and stepped out of bounds and would have been looking then at a 3rd and 10, 3rd and 9. As it is, he's looking at a 3rd and 19.
It is interesting that Monty Clark, with a 3-touchdown lead, is throwing the football here in the third quarter. That stops the clock with 9:34 left in the period.
Well, he's probably instructed Hipple, if the man is not open, get it out of bounds. Throw the percentage passes, and you saw it there. He delivered that one out of bounds.
Third and 19.
Short pass here. There it is.
To Sims, giving him some running room. 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. And Billy Sims all the way to the 31-yard line.
When you've got a horse, get him the football. Stretch the defense on this one. Good blocks by Elias and Lee in front of the runner there. And look at it right at the end. Now watch the action. Well, we're not going to see it, but he flips that ball up the woods after he goes to the ground. A good hard tackle here. And after the action is over, he flipped the ball back at him. Said, hey, none of that.
First down at the 31. Dexter Bussey. First call for Bussey today, and the man who is the all-time Lion in rushing yardage picks up another first down, 13 yards, and there's Billy Sims. You think there isn't a heart inside that man. He loves to play, and he loves to win. He's been frustrated. He said it, and he's shown it. He's broken up a table on the sidelines. He does not like to lose, and you can see that in the character of his play. Well, who does like to lose?
He does not like to lose. What he wouldn't offer, defensive coordinator, got to be going crazy on that Pittsburgh sideline.
Dexter Bussey. And Bussey, with that carry, has now tied Alte Taylor for the most rushing attempts in Detroit Lion history. He needed only 17 yards today to reach the 5,000-yard mark.
Dick, you feel the tempo from up here. I guess it's like dancing, and sometimes you get out of step. The Pittsburgh defense has just been out of step all day. Detroit able to stay one move ahead of them. Hit them inside when they were expecting it outside, and vice versa.
Second and 3. Bussey again. And he's just a handful now away from that 5,000-yard mark as they give Billy Sims a rest. And Dexter Bussey says, hey, I'll be glad to carry it. At the start today, needed 17 yards, and on the last two carries, he's picked up about 12. And he has passed Alte Taylor most carries ever by a Lion back from the University of Texas at Arlington.
Passed another Utah Stater. We got a few of our boys around.
Right, and one of them's handing the ball to him right now, the quarterback Hipple. Has about 4 or 5 more. That'll put him right at the 5,000 level. Woods and Shell drag him down.
It looks like a pinched nerve for Rick Woods as he came up head to head. A Bussey with fresh legs just attacking right there, almost knocked Woods off his feet. And listen to this crowd. Whoa.
Standing ovation for Dexter Bussey. He's hit the 5,000-yard mark. Rick Woods off the field appeared to have a pinched nerve. It's second and goal for the Lions inside the 2. There's Woods. Billy Sims is back in. Sims diving. Touchdown. And the Lions have scored more points against the Steelers than any team this year.
When you come into a game ranked 3rd in the NFL in defense, you know you've been doing things right. You haven't allowed many teams to do to you what Detroit is doing right now to the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Well, if their Olympic team needs a substitute vaulter in gymnastics in 84, they might look at the talents of this man.
Well, and you think about the rumors circulating here amongst his teammates that this is not going to be a situation that lasts long, that Billy has already signed and will be going elsewhere next year. You realize the scope of that loss to this team and to this city.
You can't let him get away. Reese McCall is okay. But what an effort as Hipple.
Watch the quarterback watching a gem of a play.
65 yards and 8 plays for Detroit. And with 6.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter, the Lions lead 30-3. And add one more. Billy Sims and the Detroit Lions dominating 31-3. Eric Hipple launching Billy Sims. I think he wanted the goal line.
Does he get excited about it? Holy mackerel. Well, he'll buy that football. He doesn't care.
That one's on its way to Briggs Stadium, and that's how it shakes for the Detroit Lions. And Billy Sims and company have a 31-3 lead, 6.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Murray to Odom at the 12. At the 25-yard line. 58, Steve Doig. Rob Rubik, 84, made the tackle. Took them 8 plays, less than 4 minutes to go the 65 yards. Dexter Bussey in the process had the crowd all excited about gaining 5,000 in his career, and Sims with the payoff. Harris, the lone running back behind Stout. And Stout rolling out of bounds at the 28-yard line. A gain of a couple.
I think the Pittsburgh press talking to Chuck Knoll, and he was recalling his first season, and they opened that year with Detroit, a game they won. And they said, "Do you remember much about that game?" He said, "No." He said it was followed by 13 defeats, and he said, "I do remember quite a bit about those games." Well, his experience here, quite a bit different than that particular experience.
Steelers had not lost and have not lost so far on the road this year. 5-0, their 3 defeats came at Three Rivers Stadium. But they're being blitzed today. A case where it appeared Jimmy Williams, a linebacker, was in the flight plan, and Stout had to throw around the linebacker, so he was outside, wide and incomplete.
Of course, this is one of the places that the Steelers miss Terry Bradshaw. Bradshaw's forte, getting the ball deep and downfield. Stout has been an effective passer on many occasions during this season, but most of the passes he throws and completes are of the short variety and not the deep ones.
Third down 8. Almost intercepted by Maurice Harvey, or was it William Graham? It was Graham, the second-year man, who had it all the way. He was reading the eyes of the quarterback.
Boy, you got to get that ball off in a hurry. You can't tip your shots. That's like telegraphing your punches. When the defense is reacting, and when they're on top of it, they'll get there ahead of the receivers.
And rolling against your throwing arm, going to the left, and then having to throw back really minimizes the area in which you can throw.
Mel Phillips, who's been coaching these defensive backs, has them all fired up. Look at, boy, they're sick to death to miss that one, but they've got more than their share today.
Hold quick. Another short kick. Robbie Martin at the 32. And he's out across the 40-yard line where Odom and Taves make the tackle. And Colquitt not at all happy about his punting, and it has not been a good day for him. 39 yards. And we'll take this timeout. Larry Brown, number 79, after 7 weeks off.
Can't be ready to play. That deeply bruised leg has kept him from playing a great deal of football. There's some fatigue on both sides. You play a short week like this, the body just doesn't have a chance to get back.
That was Graham who nearly came up with that last interception. And the Lions with the ball at the 41-yard line. Billy Sims, the lone running back. And the Steelers were in waiting. Robin Cole and Mel Blunt. Eddie Kayette with two of his prized interior linemen, Doug English and William Gay.
Well, they're a pair of real sackers there. Kayette terribly proud, just like a papa. He's proud of his boys. Done a good job of coaching the defensive line here.
Ball at the 40, a loss of a yard for Sims. He has 62 yards on the afternoon. Deep down the middle to Chadwick. 28-yard line of Pittsburgh. Yards to the free agent rookie Chadwick.
And after lulling the defense with the short passes and the running game a good part of the day, Hipple goes for the bomb, delivers it right on target, and Chadwick, showing us some fine speed, pulls away from the linebacker right there, Merriweather. You just can't match those wide receivers on those linebackers and expect it to work out properly. Safety's nowhere in sight on that one. You've got to give him some help, gentlemen.
Sims, a couple of yards. Well, we've seen the Steelers a lot during the course of the last several seasons, Merlin Olsen. I'm sitting here deliberating. I can't remember a game in which they've been so thoroughly outplayed.
I've seen them play badly. Most of their defeats, Dick, if you'll recall, they have contributed heavily with turnovers. That's been true today. But I think what you're referring to is the battle on the line of scrimmage and the individual contests. And it seems that they have lost the high percentage of those today.
Whether it's the short week or the injuries or the fact they've just caught a very hot team, the Lions, who are after the Vikings, it's been a Detroit day. Woodruff on the blitz, and Billy Sims was all alone. There wasn't a Steeler within 15 yards of Sims, but of course, in Hipple's defense, he didn't have much time to find him.
Very done, leveled Hipple, and Hipple laid there for a minute, knowing that he had missed a wide open Billy Sims, and I think would have liked to lay there a little bit longer to maybe try to get another chance for a pass like that. A sure touchdown. That one's just got to be hung out there anywhere. And Billy will go get it. But ball just overthrown.
Remember, Hipple is actually the third string quarterback behind Danielson and Comlow. And he started on a national telecast, a Monday night game, threw four touchdowns, ran for a couple of more, and was instantly known around the country. Out of the shotgun, third and nine. Gary Dunn, the fourth sack for the Steelers. Did you see the acrobatic play by Gary? Was completely somersaulted, bounced back up, and still pressured the quarterback.
Fine athlete. We have not seen Keith Willis return to the lineup, as we showed you his demise earlier. See if you can see that. Oh, there he is, diving right off the ground on the first bounce and in on the play. You're right, Dick. Excellent play. Gary Dunn slamming him over the ground.
Rick Woods is back at the 10 as Michael Black will punt for the Lions. His second kick, the other was 32, but was in the same position where he didn't have a lot of field with which to work. Did a good job of just catching that one and then sends it into the end zone. So he fielded that on one hop. Like Lou Whitaker there, picking that one off. Timeout in the Silverdome. Well, the Lions are flying. 31-3 over the Steelers. We have the ball at their 20 on the punt into the end zone. 3:03 left, third quarter. Big 218-pounder from Baylor has a first down and a little extra with Alvin Hall. We're talking the other day, Merlin, about the position you feel is the very toughest on the 49-man NFL roster, the toughest spot to play.
Well, I think it's a position that both Cliff Stout and Eric Hippel can equate to. It's the number three quarterback, the guy that carries the clipboard, has to be totally prepared with a game plan every week and knows he's not going to play, and yet has to do all of that work, and then has to stand on the sideline and work the phones and the clipboard. I think it's the toughest job on the team.
First down, Pollard again. He's out to the 40-yard line. This telecast presented by authority of the National Football League, intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Detroit Lions and the National Football League is prohibited.
Second and four at the 40.
Second down, four. 2:28 left in the quarter. Lions 31, Steelers 3. Calvin Sweeney to the 47 of Detroit. Jimmy Williams dragged him down, number 59, along with Bruce McNorton, a 12-yard gain.
Cliff Stout doing a good job of looking the defenders off on that play, initially looking in the opposite direction to the receiver and then quickly snapping back.
And we receive the increasingly bad news from the sidelines. You look at Mark Malone. Keith Willis, the top sack man, he has a sprained ankle, will not return for Pittsburgh.
Well, they better send a hospital plane for this team.
Stout pumping, throwing, up for grabs. Intercepted by Bruce McNorton. His second today, his fifth of the year. That one was up for grabs.
A pass that Stout should not have thrown, but he's got to have some help from his receivers. When the ball is up like that, if they can't get to the ball, they've got to be defensive backs and go up there and try and keep the defender from getting that ball. Sweeney, we saw him stop earlier on one play, and this will irritate his coaches as well. That ball coming down, he's got to fight for that ball, goes up and almost quits on the play until he realized the man has got it. He's got to do a better job than that, Dick.
In the meantime, you saw McNorton. He just played his man as well as you can. And look at the leaping ability, shielding his man almost like taking a rebound. A gourmet chance, and he gobbled it up. Draw to Sims. Oh, my! Well, his tailgate was flapping. His jersey in the breeze created by his own energy, and Sims all the way to the 45-yard line.
He has got to be getting tired. We told you 35 carries, a new Lion record last week, and he has been a busy man today, just ripping and shredding through the Steelers secondary. And I don't think that many people around won't tell you that that's the toughest tackling secondary or as tough and aggressive as any in the NFL. Sims has made them look bad today.
22 on that play, and Sims with 86 on the game. Last minute, third quarter. The Lions are feasting. Dexter Bussey a couple of yards. Dwayne Woodruff with the tackle. Bruce McNorton, you should be happy.
Maybe these Pittsburgh Steelers know how the Christians felt now.
That's right, a turnabout. And there's a man. Or the Lions and their fans. I don't know how well this team or franchise could absorb the loss of Sims if indeed the rumors are true that he will sign with a USFL team in Houston. You just can't, you know, you can't lose stars. You just can't let the great ones get away. And there aren't many you can put that tag on, but this man has earned it. He is a great player. Final seconds, down to 4 seconds of this third quarter, and the fans are happy in Pontiac. The end of the third quarter, the Lions 31, the Steelers 3. We'll be back after these messages from your local station.
Channel 4 wishes you a happy Thanksgiving.
Well, from all of us on NBC Sports, we wish you a most pleasant holiday. Here in the Silver Dome, the official attendance, 77,724. The Silver Dome seats over 80,000, and it was a sellout. Eric Hippel and the Lions from the Detroit 47, leading 31-3. Most points allowed by the Steelers all year. Swing it, incomplete to Bussey.
Hippel's pass intended for Bussey.
Lions using this opportunity, Dick, to put a few substitutes in the game. Rich Stringer gone in for Keith Dorney. Stringer, they're very high on him. Monty Clark says, first player I've ever had to look up to.
Time of possession, twice as much in the hands of Detroit.
Obviously, statistics favoring the Lions tremendously, and perhaps the biggest statistic other than the score, the turnovers. They just have eaten the Steelers alive today.
Robbie Martin seeing some duty. He's a wide receiver out to the left. And Ray Scott split right. Pipple on third and eight. Chadwick, and you won't see that youngster drop many like that. It was right there. Well thrown.
And from the vantage point of the quarterback, you get a chance to feel like you're right in that Detroit backfield. Ball on target, and this is just a classic error. The head went away before the ball was caught. You see the frustration, and that's something I'm sure if you could ask that young man to give the clinic, he'd say, you got to catch the ball first and look it in.
Look it into your hands. Michael Black, he lines one to Woods at the 13. 20. And Woods from Boise State, where he was part of the 1980 NCAA AA champions, has a 9-yard return. Tom Tenor made the tackle for Detroit. We have a timeout. Franco Harris, only 4 carries, 17 yards. Billy Sims has had the crowd on its feet. A couple of touchdowns. Harris, Doug English. There's no hole, and English, 258-pounder, All-Pro last year, made the tackle. Pro Bowl starter, in fact, the last 2 years, number 78. Wonder, what are your feelings if Terry Bradshaw were completely healthy, if that arm, elbow, muscles were okay? Would we see him?
Interesting question, Dick, and I'm not so sure we would.
Stout, no catch, the ball bounced into Garrity.
Chuck Knoll, the kind of a coach that really, once you get things going, once you've been down the road with him for a while, he'll stay with you. I don't think he'll open this quarterbacking contest back up until next training camp. Indeed, if he does then, although if Terry were healthy, I'm sure Terry deserves a chance to get back and start. But there is a possibility that he would bring him onto the roster for an occasion like this, when his deep passing ability could be helpful.
Out to Franco. Not much there except William Graham, number 33.
It has been a dominant day for the Detroit Lions, dominating both the offensive line of scrimmage and the defensive line of scrimmage. The numbers for Franco, extremely disappointing, but at the same time, when you're not getting the performance up front, virtually impossible for a running back to be getting any yardage.
An empty note that he now has caught 300 passes, 3 yards on that one. Robbie Martin back at the line, 32. Boy, Colquitt lines it again. 25, 30, 35, and out to the 40. And even though Colquitt got some distance on it, when you kick them that low, there's just too much time for that return man to break in the clear. It's been all Lions. Today's Thanksgiving game is being brought to you by the new Chrysler Corporation, moving America ahead with advanced technology. By AT&T, the more you hear, the better we sound. And by Budweiser, proud sponsor of the U.S. Olympic team. For all you do, this Bud's for you. Oh, I do enjoy those little musical bridges, the little classics here on this Thanksgiving Thursday. Mark Malone, who has not taken a snap from center all year in game action, apparently is going to see some duty, Merlin.
Why not? Things are not going well. Looks a little bit like Tom Selleck to you.
He certainly does.
Yes, he does. Send him out to Hawaii. He can take a lot of heat off Tom.
Who's Tom Selleck play for?
The baseball player, didn't he?
William Graham. Relaxing on the sidelines. The Lions have the ball at their 40-yard line. Pipple still at quarterback. Sims is still in the game, and a fumble.
And a whistle before the snap, apparently. Hipple did fall on the loose ball.
Been a couple of occasions today that Steve Mott has apparently missed the snap. But the young man who's a fine center, he's created a problem or two today. One snap that went over the head. But okay. And I think perhaps, again, when you have that many people on the line moving, it's usually the center who's missed the count.
Steve Mott, number 52, the center. It's interesting that Mott's idol, and he's not in there now.
No,
it looks like Tenor is in there. That maybe explains why there was a fumble. But
sure does.
Mott, the rookie from Alabama, even picked 52 because his idol's Mike Webster, having a chance to play against him today.
That helps me to understand why the snap was missed.
First and 15. Oh! Hipple tripped over the 30-yard line and still gets up. Incomplete.
Now, occasionally, quarterback falls down like that, disappears. You end up with a big play. Defensive backs can't figure out where he's gone. Things slow down. Looks like he hooked the foot of on the carpet here. Maybe the foot of one of his retreating guards, Homer Elias, knocked him down. He's still quick enough to get up, delivered the pass, but unfortunately not into anyone's hands. There's Mott on the sideline, talking to Fred Hoagland, the offensive line coach here. Just terribly pleased with the way this young man has come on. Not drafted that high in the draft, but has come in and taken over number one responsibility as a center. And that's a tough job today. All the calls he has to make.
Second down and 15. And it's Amos Fowler who is the center. Billy Sims tackled by Keith Gary after a short gain to the 38-yard line. So it's Fowler. We want the Tenor family to be upset with us. He's at guard, and it was Fowler who has replaced Mott at center. Veteran from Southern Mississippi. Gary Danielson, perhaps we'll see him before the day is out. Oh, I can almost smell the aroma of a pumpkin pie wafting. Little gravy and a little extra.
I'm afraid I'm going to have leftovers. I got to get all the way to the mountains.
We are leftovers. Hipple throwing long for Chadwick. No, he was out of bounds. He did not get the second foot down as his momentum carried him out of bounds. 1 foot in, 1 foot out.
But that's a great strike. That's a prettily thrown pass down that sideline. Young man not quite disciplined enough to keep his feet in bounds, but still a well-executed play. Count the steps now. One inside. Second one right on the line. Yep. Good call by the officials. There's Hipple. Boy, he threw a strike on it.
So the punting team on. Michael Black with Rick Woods at the other end for Pittsburgh. Down at the 30, a flag has been dropped back at the line of scrimmage, and holding is the call against the Lions. We'll see if Pittsburgh elects to have them kick over again. It was only a 32-yard punt. And Mark Malone asking whether they're going to take the penalty or not, but it's obvious that Malone will come in as the quarterback. It'll be the first time all season long that Cliff Stout has not taken the snap from center for Pittsburgh. Malone has not played for a couple of years, probably best known for the fact that he has caught only one NFL pass, and that was for 90 yards and a touchdown.
Holding, still fourth down.
They make him kick it over, hoping they'd gone after, tried to block that last kick, and I think they're trying to put a little pressure on Mike Black back there. Young man made a couple of mistakes last week. Pittsburgh would love to see one here. Not so sure that Stout's sorry to see the bench at this point in the game.
Ooh, almost blocking. It'll be a penalty.
Yeah.
Sam Washington ran into the kicker. Woods runs into the Lions at the 46-yard line, but the penalty will be against Washington, who was right in on top of Black and did make contact.
31 and 41, Washington, and two of the defenders in very quickly. Looked like they had a chance at the ball. Donnie Shell in there along with Washington. From the punter's standpoint, look how quickly they're on top of him. Washington is up right in front of it and hits the foot. Now watch the foot extend here. He misses the ball and extended all the way out, ends up running into the kicker's foot. almost a great play, but as it ends up, they turn the ball back to the Lions, and that's all Pittsburgh needed, more Lion offense.
Automatic first down at the 33-yard line.
Chuck, that's the special teams coach there. He can't yell for the special teams coach.
Chuck Noll in his 15th year. There have been few games of this sort in the last 7 years. Another penalty, this time against the veteran Mel Blunt for the early hit. And the truth of the matter is that for Noll, the one thing for certain, this is a case where the head coach burns the films. I don't think he can go back and put your team through it.
Interference, 47 defense, first down.
Because no one has really done anything very well for Pittsburgh today.
No, there aren't many bright spots in this day. And one thing we've always noticed about Pittsburgh, when they're having a bad day, there's an area that clears out around Chuck Noll. Now, they give him a lot of room. He'll start moving one direction. You notice those guys, they'll back right up. Look how much room he has on that sideline. I don't blame him.
Yep, give the head man some space. Steelers 82 yards now in penalties. Here comes Billy Sims. Surprising that Sims is still in the game.
I'm just thinking the same thing. The one thing you don't want at this point is to get your number one man hurt. And Sims has already done his job. Time is clicking down. Just over 12 minutes to go in the game. It's virtually the way the game is being played, an impossible situation for the Steelers, and yet Monty Clark still has Sims in the ballgame.
Green Bay and the Lions, both 6-6, one game behind Minnesota. The Vikings play at New Orleans on Sunday. Sims again, maybe they just want him to get his 100 yards. Whoops, Sims and David Little. Sims saying, hey, you heard the whistle, let me go.
Sims is an intense football player. It is frustration in that loss in Houston, and that certainly, if you want to look at the highs and lows in this season, that game, the low, this game to date, certainly the high. Well, you saw the hand go to the face mask there, and I think that's what irritated Sims, even though he did not use the face mask, hand was into the face.
You think he doesn't have leg strength? Did you see how he fought off Little? 11:15 left in the game. 31-3 Detroit. Incomplete. Intended for Chadwick. Well covered by Harvey Clayton, a rookie from Florida State. Franco, he's giving the world some room.
Well, when you've been through the good days, he must also be able to take the pressure on the bad days. This is not one that Franco will write about in his diary.
As I say, the bad news is we got clobbered on Thanksgiving. The good news is, no matter what, we're still in first place. Black
lined that one.
Hit it right through the end zone. And it'll be first down Pittsburgh at the 20-yard line. Well, the Detroit Lions in this 44th annual Thanksgiving Day about to even up their record 21-21. Apparently, Gary Danielson will quarterback the Lions on their next possession. There's the remaining Detroit schedule. They have 12 days to prepare for Minnesota. Thursday game, of course, off this weekend, and then they don't play till Monday night against the Vikings. That, of course, will be a direct battle for first place. Frank Pollard running hard. Fantetti and Hall made the tackle for the Steelers with a two-game lead prior to today. Cleveland chasing them. It'll be Cincinnati at home, at New York on a Saturday, and they finish at Cleveland. So a Cleveland win this weekend with a Pittsburgh loss, that would be a one-game lead, and they still have to face Cleveland in the finale. So they're hardly home free.
And the Jets are playing better. Certainly a big victory for them the other night. That's not going to be an easy game away.
Running the ball and catching the ball, and he's out to the 35 with a first down before Bobby Watkins can make the tackle. Mark Malone thus has his first completion of this last two seasons. He's thrown the ball only 88 times. As you see, the man he's replaced, Cliff Stout. Malone, 45 for 88 as a pro. Three touchdowns, five intercepted, all in 1981. Now the Steelers trailing 31-3 here in the fourth period. Less than 10 minutes remaining. Collard back inside into the arms of Gary Cobb. Doug English trailing the play. Pollard stopped at the 39 after a gain of four.
Not much to salvage in a game like this, Dick. You begin to just gradually put it behind you. And I think you may be absolutely on the head with it that in a game that's as ugly as this one, Chuck Noll may decide not even to show it to his players. Just put it away.
Clark already said that regardless of what his team did, they'll have every time off until next Monday. That ball seemed to be trapped.
Well,
they
was.
Call it a catch. Now the other official comes in and said no catch.
Up off the ground.
Little disagreement with the officials, but from our angle, it appeared the ball bounced in. Yes, and that's by majority is the ruling.
Well, and I think that's a good thing that they're doing these days. Very often the officials, if they're a little bit unsure, they'll say, let's get it together. Did you see it? Did you see it? And in that case, obvious to our camera that the ball did indeed skip off the ground. The official right on top of it, not able to see the ground underneath it. But wisely, the call made by those who had a better vantage view.
Third down and six. Noll chewing on someone.
I think he's got a lot of choices over there today.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's not the kind of meal he wanted, though. Malone wobbles it out there, and in a way it's a good thing as that ball was tipped that Alvin Hall was in perfect position for an interception. Well, we want to send along a special happy Thanksgiving to one of the outstanding people in sport, Mr. Art Rooney, the owner of the Pittsburgh Steelers. They too are celebrating their 50th anniversary. I know he's with a holiday in Philadelphia with family, and one of his very favorite players, he told me, was Bill Dudley, running back, who also starred here with the Detroit Lions, one of the eight Lions to be in the Hall of Fame. Bring back some memories. We want to run down those Detroit Lions who've been so honored. Colquitt to Martin. 25. 30. 40. One man to beat, the punter, and Robbie Martin's all the way for a touchdown. Boyish 5'8 Martin, 81 yards.
I think Monty Clark is on the sideline wishing he could bank a few of these points for that game against Minnesota. But Martin just turning it on, and a little carelessness. Certainly some fatigue on the part of these Steelers, but they're not the proud championship team that they need to be if they're going to go on into the playoffs and do well.
Well, a smoke bomb has been thrown on the field by someone totally inconsiderate of all else here. That's the first touchdown return for the Lions this year, the first ever for Robbie Martin, and as an ex-Steeler, it must have felt especially good for him to make that romp of 81 yards, and the Lions lead 38-3. Russ Thomas, the general manager of the Lions, in the Detroit suite, and how sweet it has been for his club. And Robbie Martin, happy young man, 81 yards for a score.
Sometimes it comes in bunches.
Well, I guess as a player you realize that sometimes those 21-20 losses are tougher to overcome than when you really get belted.
Interesting, Dick, that you're never quite as good as you seem on a day like today, or quite as bad.
Well said. Tim Harris dropped at the 23-yard line by Rick Kane, number 32 of the Lions. Horace King was was also in on the play. Mark Malone on the field for Pittsburgh. Lots for you on this Thanksgiving weekend on NBC. And for you golfers, how would you like to be in that foursome? Nicholas Watson, Palmer, and Player. That's like the Hall of Fame of the sport, competing for $360,000. The Skins game Saturday and Sunday, 4 o'clock on Saturday Eastern time. And I guess they won't play for any hole that's, well, the minimum is $10,000, and they'll carry over if no one wins a hole. Should be a lot of fun. Weaving his way to the 30, to the 32, and near a first down. Martin Moss from UCLA, number 63, made the tackle as the Lions' second string getting a chance to see some duty. Gabe Rivera's not here today, and I know you want to send along your personal best, Merlin.
Certainly delighted in watching that young man as he made progress. Senior sack, of course, paralyzed, and we hope getting stronger. We'd want him to enjoy this broadcast. I'm sure it's hard for him to enjoy this broadcast. These are his teammates out here.
Pollard, big hole, 45. All the way to the Lion, 36-yard line, and that's the longest play of the day for the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Picked up an article from one of the Pittsburgh papers in the locker room in Pittsburgh. His locker is just the same as it was the day he left it. Still very closely held by his teammates, who think often of him, and we do too. Send along our best to him.
While he was in the hospital, his wife presenting him with a son. So even in that tragedy, and as he fights back, and he is doing that, improving condition, plus welcoming a new Rivera to the world. Malone, incomplete. McNorton on single coverage against Calvin Swinney, doing a good job again. We understand that that lovely lady and those youngsters in there are the family of Ken Fantetti.
Yeah, they've got to be pleased with the fantastic day that Fantetti and these Lions have had today.
Oh, he's already a winner with those faces at home,
sure,
huh? How'd you like to see them around the table? 36-yard line. There's Fantetti, who calls the signals, leading tackler for the Lions. Pollard to about the 33-yard line. Hey, we teased you a bit when we talked about the Detroit Lions, who are in the National Football League Hall of Fame down in Canton, Ohio. Well, I remember growing up near this spot as a farm boy over in Armada, Michigan, watching Bobby Lane and Yale Larry and Joe Schmidt and Jack Christensen, those champion teams of the 50s. All of those four men all now in the Hall of Fame, along with Dutch Clark, the very first quarterback of the Lions, Bill Dudley, Night Train Lane, who played here in Detroit, and Alex Wojciechowicz, all with Detroit Lion history in the Hall of Fame.
Third and six, and intercepted by Roosevelt Barnes. And Barnes on the run. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30. One man to beat. And Malone knocks him out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Barnes, who was known as a basketball player at Purdue, he lettered 4 years, was on that Final Four team in 1980, played only 1 year of college football, and Roosevelt almost had a big Thanksgiving treat.
As he walked in toward the locker room today, I stopped him. I said, "How do you feel about this one?" He said, "Hey, I feel great." He said, "I'm going to go out and pick one off today." Amazing. He just did it. And had it not been for Mark Malone coming after him, he would have carried it in for a touchdown. Ooh, look at the shot that Malone took. Still gets up off the ground and then comes all the way down. Just a couple of weeks ago, we saw Mark Wilson make this same kind of play and end his season. Malone taking the defender, Rosie Barnes, out of bounds, just short of the touchdown.
70 yards on the return for Roosevelt Barnes as the Lions have 5 steals and they're about to add to their 38-3 lead. And believe it or not, Billy Sims is still in the game. He's got the ball and a flag down. I believe there was motion in the backfield of Detroit. Jan Hippel, the wife of the Lion quarterback. The Hippel clan right there. And
baby hugging her own little child.
Dick, I think the quarterback's wives really have the toughest job in the stands. Everyone knows that that's the quarterback's wife. And, you know, the quarterback is so visible that when he throws a bad pass, they all turn and look at her. I mean, it's especially tough on the bad days. She's got to be happy today. Eric had himself an afternoon.
Against the Lions, it'll be first and goal at the 9. Well, even the wives of defensive linemen. I know a pretty lady, Susan Olsen, who's had to defend you.
She wasn't afraid to smack him on the head.
No, I wouldn't have said anything bad about you. Still won't. Billy Sims sticking his head into a crowd of Steelers, and David Little makes sure he's down at the 5. Little from Miami, and of course the younger brother of one of the all-time Dolphin greats, Larry Little, the many-time All-Pro guard of the Miami Dolphins.
Dick, I wonder why Sims is still out there. He must have, he must want that 100. I think he must say, I'd like to stay in and get the 100 yards.
He's got 98.
Well, if he gets it and goes in from there, he's got his 100.
That's what he's looking for.
He has
two touchdowns. Despite the fact he missed 3 games this year, he's already over 750 yards on the season. Gary Danielson to Billy Sims. Was he inbounds? No.
He dropped the ball.
Couldn't quite hang on. He was trying to stay inbounds and catch it too.
Well, he wanted to turn up. He knew he was approaching that end line, and he wanted to turn into the end zone. And he's trying to balance the ball. Well, watch him here. First, he does an excellent job of getting open, screening outside. Rick Woods, 22, trying to get there. Now he's bouncing the ball, and look, he wants to turn into that end zone and just made the turn before he got control of that football. And, well, he's unhappy. He can't be too unhappy, but he just blew an opportunity to get 7 more on the board.
Great job of covering the play. Our NBC crew working on this holiday and doing a great job as always. Third and goal.
Wide open is Jeff Chadwick, his second pro touchdown, and the Lion receivers have been incredibly wide open all day.
You saw the big smile from Gary Danielson. Boy, they are having themselves an afternoon. Again, they wish they could just put a few of these in their pocket and save them for the Minnesota game. Mike Merriweather, number 57, slipped down on the coverage. It appeared that he was trying to get back into the corner of the end zone. No luck.
Murray adds the extra point, and all season long, never have the Steelers scored so few while the others have enjoyed so many points. It's 45-3.
Some of the Steeler fans, and of course that's just joking around here, they're probably Michiganders who have come out to cheer for the Steelers for whatever reason, and now they're wearing the colors but hiding their faces. Well, we won't.
Even on a day like today, the Steelers can be proud of their record. They won't have many days like this one.
As we said, they're still in first. On Sunday, New England at New York, Baltimore, Cleveland, Houston and Tampa, the early games after NFL 83 at 12:30. Buffalo and the Rams, cross-country affair, Denver at San Diego, Kansas City, Seattle. So join us for more on Sunday. The heavyweight champion Larry Holmes tomorrow night live on NBC. The Skins game, NBC Sports World has that Hagler Duran fight for you on Saturday, and Sunday football. What a week of activity here on NBC.
I think we talked about the crowd and the role they might play in this game early, especially if the Lions got off to a fast start. Well, the crowd has lived up to expectations and beyond, as have the Lions.
Harris will not run it out. The ball, of course, the impetus from the kicking team, even though Harris may have touched it in the field of play, goes back in the end zone and he takes the touchback. Heisman Award winner. Okay. Merlin Olsen. I was going to, well, don't show it to Merlin. I want to see how many of these Heisman Award winners that have played with the Detroit Lions you can name. I'll give you a hint.
I can get one right off the bat. Hopalong Cassidy. I do remember that one.
I thought you might say Billy Sims.
No, I got Billy Sims. You're really making it easy now. Well, let's let the folks at home think on that one for just
a minute. Hopalong Cassidy, Howard Hopalong, indeed, for the Lions from Ohio State. Mark Malone intercepted his last pass. Oh, my goodness. Calvin Sweeney belted by Maurice Harvey. And Sweeney is hurt. It has not only been a disaster on the scoreboard for Pittsburgh, the injury list has been incredibly high for the Steelers.
I'm sure that John Stallworth, Steve Corson were angry that they didn't get to come on the trip after watching the way this game has gone. Maybe they were the lucky ones. This has been a brutal physical game. That ball bouncing away.
And that's what we were talking about in NFL 83. The helmet is so... protects one so well, it becomes a weapon. Watch this. The helmet right into the chin. And, of course, that's a legal tackle, but in the old days when you had that leather mop on your head, you didn't throw your head into a body that way.
No. You throw the body across or you wrap the arms around. You didn't attack with the helmet.
And that was indeed an attacking play, and we're not putting the finger at Maurice Harvey. It's, you know, every defensive back, that's how they're taught, that's how they hit. Okay, do you have the one? Can I throw in one just only
right,
because he was one of my favorites out of Notre Dame and was one of the start around 1950 of the Lions' success of the 50s under Buddy Parker and George Wilson, Leon Hart.
Oh, okay. That's one I shouldn't have missed. That's one of the big guys.
Well, there are three others, and one was when I was a tyke. I used to copy number 37 of the Lions who played at SMU. The Doker.
Doker. All right. Well, see, I haven't been around as long as you have been.
I did ask for that, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
Well, there's one here that you did play against, I think.
Steve Owens.
No, Frankie Sinkwood. A fumble. Doug Inglis was around the football, but I believe the Steelers were able to come up with it. Frank Pollard after his own fumble. And it was covered by the quarterback, Mark Malone. Here's the list. Six Heisman winners. And Billy Sims at the top of the list most recently. Frankie Sinkwich, great quarterback at Georgia. Hart from Notre Dame. Walker of SMU. Cassidy, Ohio State. Owens of Oklahoma.
Impressive list of trophy winners. And I don't think any of them with more courage and better demonstration of football than we've seen today from Billy Sims.
William Gay.
He's had himself a day, too. Boy, he had been all over the field and up in the face of those Pittsburgh quarterbacks. And at some point here, I think Chuck Knoll is just going to take off that headset and say it doesn't make any sense anymore.
I think you made the most candid comment, and it certainly illustrates this game more than anything. When you said one team isn't really that good and the other team certainly isn't that bad. 45-3. You can't take this too seriously, otherwise you would be better than 6-6 if you're a Lion player or fan. And for the Steelers, they're 9-3. They've been almost humiliated, but their season is still a very positive one. Robbie Martin, he's on the run again, runs into his own man, and down he goes at the 49-yard line. Russell Davis made the tackle.
There has to be a growing concern on the part of Chuck Knoll, losing two games in a row, and especially in light of all of the injuries he has today. The time you want to play your best football going into the finale of the season. Looking at that number, with Cleveland just two games behind, you don't have that much room.
Cleveland win on Sunday, and they're just one game back.
You bet.
And they play the Steelers in the final game of the season. We'll be seeing here on NBC. Monty Clark went to the same high school out there in Kingsburg, California, as the great Olympian Rafer Johnson, his brother Jimmy Johnson, all pro with the 49ers. And they're putting the heat on the Vikings. Green Bay still a factor in that NFC Central Division race. And Sims, short yardage, a couple to the 49, and that should be right about 100 yards for Sims.
Well, let's see if he does come out after picking up the 100.
101, according to our master statistician, Joe Costanza.
He's looking to the sideline. That must be what he's working at today.
Don't forget, on NFL 83, a very appropriate feature, a report on the important measures being taken to prevent some of the injuries in pro football.
35 rushes last Sunday, 25 today. That's impressive.
Well, he's got 12 days to rest. There goes Sims again down to the 44-yard line, and that's just to make certain that he has his 100. David Little made the tackle. Now, the Lions have that advantage, not only a win today, but a long breather before they play the Minnesota Vikings. Now Sims comes out. Now the crowd that remains. I think you're right, Merlin. I think he asked Monty Clark. It's Thanksgiving Day. I want my 100.
I don't blame him. I'd say he has earned the respect of the Pittsburgh Steelers defense. He's given them a little bit of lesson out there.
Dexter Bussey has the first down inside the Pittsburgh 40 with 3:18 left, and the Steelers down 45-3 to a Detroit Lion team that has put everything together today, offensively and defensively, and Chuck Knoll would have to search a long time to find any positive out of this performance.
One thing you know about the Pittsburgh Steelers, though, Dick, they are a confident winner. They've been winning for a long time, and I think they'll be able to put this game behind them. You see one of the very negative aspects of the game, the ability to rush the football. We talked about the importance of the running game early and how critical it was to this Detroit team. You saw what the lack of rushing has done to the Pittsburgh Steelers today.
Thompson, Vince Thompson, playing for the injured James Jones. And again, the Lions doing this while the Steelers have had their injuries. The Lions started without two offensive men, Leonard Thompson and James Jones. They're two leading receivers, both with 40 catches. They didn't need them today.
Well, I honestly believe if Pittsburgh had been able to shut off Billy Sims early, this game would have taken on an entirely different complexion, because then Detroit would have had to throw the football, would not have had the options.
The baton is up. We're at the two-minute mark. And now another fantastic finish. With Merlin Olsen, Dick Enberg, from all of us at NBC on this Thanksgiving, thank you for saving a seat for us. The Detroit Lions, 45, Pittsburgh, 3. And the brows are furrowed and the lips of Chuck Knoll are pursing by the second. Keith Carey makes the tackle on Thompson.
I said a few moments ago, about time for him to take the headset off and say it doesn't matter, and it's gone. The game certainly is gone, and be some time for thoughtful deliberation. There'll be a lot of pain in a trip home for the Steelers. And it's almost going to be more difficult for them with this long week. They'd like to get another game under their belt and a chance to atone for this one. This is the one they're going to have to think about through that layoff until they get back on the field.
Gary Danielson and the Lions still throwing the football to Thompson. And he is down at the 40-yard line, bringing up fourth down and about 10. Thanks to our head men down there in the truck calling the shots, Ted Nathanson and Larry Cirillo. All the men and women here working on the holiday. Some smiles on that line sideline. And well, it should be. We want to thank also our help in the booth, Walt Doherty, Ron Grubbs, Buck Jersey, Ron Knight, Joe Costanza. 1 minute remaining. Rick Woods back, a crowd of 77,000 on a sellout, watching a big day for the Detroit Lions. Well, let's acknowledge those folks who have played such a prominent role, not only in today's telecast, but during the course of this NFL season. And with this acknowledgement, our thanks, our executive producer is Michael Weissman. Ted Nathanson, our coordinating producer, and the director today, Larry Cirillo, our producer. Ted Nathanson directing today, Steve Cimino, and Joe Michaels. He's also our conductor of our NBC orchestra. brains of Rossini, I believe. We invite you to stay tuned to NFL 83. They're going to try to chat with Billy Sims. We'll get the insight on whether or not he indeed was the one who asked to stay in the game when obviously it had been won by Detroit so that he could get his 100 yards. Henry Odom straight ahead, and that will be the final play of the game. In Detroit and in the state of Michigan, Thanksgiving Day belongs to the Lions.
And for the Pittsburgh Steelers, a long and painful ride home, but they'll be back.
The final score, Detroit 45, Pittsburgh 3, the most lopsided win for the Lions in nearly 15 years, and they beat a quality team thoroughly today. Monty Clark's Lions by 42 points.